I'm Kaylee, and today I'm going to tell you about my top 10 mysteries that I've read in the last 10 years. I do love a good mystery, and in the last 10 years, I have certainly read some pretty wonderful ones. Some of these are just standalone mysteries, some of them are part of series, but we're going to jump in and tell you about some of my favorite mysteries. So these mysteries are not really in any particular order, they're just kind of in the order of how I thought of them to put them on this list. The first one on my list is the Lord Peter Wimsey series by Dorothy Sayers. Every mystery in this series is absolute gold. Lord Peter Wimsey is this gentleman detective who is so rich that he's bored, and so he goes around solving mysteries. He is a perfect gentleman, absolutely proper and compassionate and graceful at all times. And about midway through the series, then he falls in love with the beautiful mystery writer, Harriet Vane. Every one of these mysteries is so complex. There's a lot of stuff going on. There's a lot of side characters. I can never figure out the mystery before the end. It always surprises me. I really love the intelligent and emotional writing style. The next one on my list is the Mrs. Polifax series. Mrs. Polifax is not necessarily so much mystery as it is spies, but there's definitely, you know, a mystery element in there. Mrs. Polifax is an older lady and she gets bored with being retired and decides to become an American spy. So of course she has all kinds of wonderful adventures and, you know, everything goes horribly wrong and she gets captured by the enemy or something and has to escape. All kinds of wonderful stuff. I just love the Mrs. Polifax mysteries. It's really fun and just interesting because she travels all over the world. There's all these different cultures and different people that she meets. So there's just a lot of good stuff in there. My next mystery is a standalone. It's The Ghost and Mrs. Muir. This one isn't like a murder mystery or anything. It's more of a ghost mystery in the beginning because there's all these strange happenings around the house and Mrs. Muir discovers there's a ghost in her house. But then she ends up befriending the ghost. And then the mystery becomes, will Mrs. Muir just fall in love with the ghost and live her life just with a ghost in like this fantasy world? Or is she going to go out and connect with real people again? My next favorite mystery series is more of a middle grade or YA, I guess. It's the Enola Holmes series by Nancy Springer. Enola is the little sister of Mycroft and Sherlock Holmes, and she does not want to go to like a ladies' finishing school and have to wear corsets and stuff, so she runs away in disguise and starts up her own detective agency in London, all the while staying away from her brother Sherlock, who is hunting for her to try to make her go to finishing school. Enola solves missing persons cases and robberies and the occasional murder. It's really witty and fun, and Enola is such an interesting character. She's just lovely. My next one is Petronella Saves Nearly Everyone. Petronella's rich family are having a garden party, and her uncle, I think it is like this revered scientist. And so there are a lot of very important scientific fancy people at this garden party, and everything goes horribly wrong when several of the guests go missing and there are kidnapping notes, and unfortunately a lot of the clues appear to be insects, but her weird eccentric uncle has suddenly decided that he just loves eating insects, and so he's eating some of the clues. He needs to stop. And there's a mystery to solve, and there's burglary, and possible spies who are trying to steal scientific secrets. There's just all kind of stuff happening. And of course, Petronella is the only one who can save everyone, nearly everyone. It's really hilarious and silly and funny, and it's just a rollicking good time. The next one is Suddenly at His Residence by Christiana Brand. This is your typical murder mystery where Sir Richard or Sir Robert or whoever it was is suddenly found dead out in the garden, and it must have been someone in the manor house. And it's up to the inspector to unravel the clues and figure out who who is the murderer. This one has really sharp writing style. I really like just how crisp everything is in the plot and with the characters and everything. It really grabs your attention. One of my favorite Agatha Christie's that I've read in the last 10 years was Dead Man's Folly. This is a mystery that just has so many twists and turns and a lot of history where, like, someone was murdered years and years and years ago, and now that connects to the present murder that we're investigating. So there's a lot of layers to this mystery. And of course, Agatha Christie's writing style is absolute perfection. Everything in this book is really wonderful. The next mystery series is Aunt Dimity by Nancy Atherton. This is another mystery series that is very, very silly. Lori discovers that her godmother, who she has never met, has died, leaving a mystery behind, along with a supernatural journal that allows Lori to write to and from her godmother from the grave. It sounds really morbid, but it's actually very hilarious and silly. And Lori goes on to move to England, and she gets married and has kids and, like, all kinds of stuff in different episodes. I mean, in different books in the series, and there's always some mystery to solve. There's a burglary or a kidnapping or, you know, some kind of ancient code that's been left by the ancestors, or I don't know, there's all kinds of stuff, all types of different mysteries that Lori solves along with the help of her ghostly Aunt Dimity. Another favorite standalone mystery is The Wrong Box by Robert Louis Stevenson. This is a mystery spoof with one ridiculous circumstance after another when a body goes missing and is lost in the wrong box. The characters are all running in circles around each other, and there are far too many uncles. Everybody and their mother seems to have a helpful uncle waiting in the wings of every scene. The dialogue is snappy, the whole thing is just completely wild. It's a really funny mystery. Another mystery series that I love is the Miss Silver mystery. This kind of maybe takes its inspiration a little bit from Agatha Christie's Miss Marple. Miss Silver is a retired old lady who used to be a teacher or something, I think. And she loves to knit. And of course, she has befriended a police detective and she helps him out with some of his cases. And of course, because she's just this sweet, compassionate little old lady, people tend to confide in her important clues and important secrets that they would not tell the police. All the Miss Silver mysteries are just a really fun, really good, you know, just mysteries you can sink your teeth into. Just some good stories. And those are my favorite 10 mysteries that I've read in the last 10 years. Of course, I have many other mysteries that I really, really love and that are my favorites, but these are just the ones from the last 10 years. Please leave me a comment down below and let me know what is your favorite mystery. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and remember, the right book in the right hands at the right time can change the world.